So you're watching this video because you want to find out about tonsil stones and if they're making your breath smell. Coming up to the holiday season, you want minty fresh breath and you want to know what your options are, and there's always options. My name is Dr JC Hodge. I'm an ear, nose and throat specialist from South Australia. If you want more information about myself or techniques that I use, you can go to my website, which is over here, www.drjchodge.com.au. If you like this video and find it useful, then subscribe to my channel. Push the notification button and that will give you updates on videos that I'm releasing. And make sure you give me the big thumbs up. That way YouTube will share this with other users that might find this useful. So the best way to talk about tonsil stones is to show you a little picture. Wasn't very much good at art at school, but essentially this is a mouth you're looking into it. This is the dangly bit called the uvula. And these are the tonsils. You can see how I've drawn it. You've got this sort of little crypts here. And that's essentially where tonsil stones are formed. All that lining of the tonsil sheds off like skin does. This is called mucosa, it's the lining on the inside. And essentially forms this bacterial mothership. And people who have these will tell you they stink, you know, they're bad. Occasionally they'll self-express. Now this one's an outie tonsil, and this one's an innie tonsil. And that's important. Now you often don't have one of each, but that does give you some management options. So the first thing you can do is ignore it. It's entirely benign. It'll just give you bad breath. Second option is to self-express. You can use a cotton bud and you can sort of poke it out. Some people can do that. Some people have got a strong gag reflex, so that won't work. And then there's a traditional surgical options. There's no medicine that's going to fix this. No spray, tablets, those sort of things. And for this sort of tonsil, or any tonsil, traditionally you take the tonsil out. That's fairly brutal. You know, and the punishment's got to fit the crime. You've got a bit of bad breath. 2 weeks off work. 10% bleed rate risk in adults. Half of those have to go back to hospital, half of those go back to theatre. It's really painful, and that's because you can't rest the throat. So you need strong painkillers, they have come with a lot of side effects. If you have ankle surgery, you can put it up and ice it, but the problem with the throat is you've got to talk, you've got to hiccup, you've got to swallow, you've got to breathe. So you're constantly sort of poking a stick at this wound, and it's really quite unpleasant. So the other option is to debulk the tonsil. Now, you can't do that if you've got an innie because there's nothing sticking out. This is all embedded into the muscle, into the pharynx. But over here, we've got an outie. It's a bit like belly buttons tonsils. And what you can do here is you can just shave this off. I use a plasma device, which disrupts molecules and dissolves tissues at very low temperature. I've got a video on this for obstructive sleep apnea in children. It's a very similar technique. And what this does, it basically gets rid of all these little crypts. So you can't have any more stones. It's much less painful, the recovery's quicker, you return to work after a few days of Panadol. It's a really good option. It also leaves behind functioning tonsil tissue, and you need it because tonsil tissue helps you fight infection, and we're in the middle of a COVID pandemic, and we don't really know the effect of removing adult tonsils are in this sort of current environment. So if you can leave it behind, you should try to. For more information, go to my website. Again, it's up here, www.drjchodge.com.au. And if you've got any comments, just write them down below and I'll respond when I get a chance. If you found this useful, then make sure you share it. Thank you.